Hello, Klaus here, and welcome back to yet another video here at the channel. So, not that long ago, my laptop at home died on me and I needed to do a replacement. So, I choose to go with the Mac M1 Mini, and I'm just going to run some different tests on my studio setup, which is a PC, and I'll show you the specs right here. So in this video, I'm going to do a number of different tests, render tests, and also how it runs with different effects and stuff like that. So if you're into videos like that, let me know down in the comments below and let me know if you want me to test out something else. Okay, with that out of the way, let's get right to the video. Okay, so for the first test here, we are going to, on the Mac, going to take one of the effects, the face refinement tool, and in this test we're just going to test out how fast it's actually tracking this clip. So we're not going to add any of the effects, we're just going to do the analyzing of the clip here, and it goes pretty darn smooth, I think, here on the Mac. It's doing a pretty good job. So now we're going to do the exact same test here on the PC, and we're going to analyze that as well, just starting out here. Well, that's also doing a pretty nice job, I think. It goes pretty fast on both systems. So here we have both systems side by side and running through here. So as you see right here, they're pretty similar in speed, but the Mac is a little tad faster than the PC in this case. So for this test, we're just running the effects now with a lot of face refinement, and we can see that the frame rates are not necessarily super fast, just running them normally here on the Mac. But if we go up to the playback and we put in some render cache and change that to smart, after rendering it will run very smooth, as you see right here, with effects on. So now we're doing the exact same test on PC with render cache on, because it was running the same way as the Mac. In this test, we're going to take the film damage on the Mac, and we're just going to push spacebar here, and as you see, it runs with 15 frames a second, which is not bad, but it's not good either. So if we go back to the edit page and we put on render cache, you can see that it's running 24 frames as it should, no problem. So now we're doing the exact same thing on the PC, and I'll just run the clip here, and it runs it pretty darn smooth. However, this was running with the smart render on. So if we take off that and we are going to put none on and we'll push play, it will still run it pretty fast, not dropping a frame. So in this case, the PC is actually a little bit better. If we go to the next test where we are going to add film grain here on the Mac, I'm just going to use like 16 millimeter, and these are my grain. I'm going to take some texture. I'm just going to bump up the grain size and the aspect ratio and strength of the grain, just to give it something to work with. So normally you wouldn't see grain like this, but for this test that we just fine. So that's running pretty fine with 24 frames a second. And for this test, there is no render thing. It's without any smart render. So we'll do the same for the PC. And again, we're going to bump up the texture, the grain size, the aspect ratio, and also the strength of the grain. And let's just go back to the edit page here. And again, it's running fine. There's no render cache enabled in this, so that's working just fine. So for the next test, we're going to add in watercolors, and it's a pretty heavy effect for your system. And if we try to push the spacebar right here, you'll see it's running one frame a second in the color page, which is not very good at all. So we'll go to the edit page, and in the edit page, if playing, it will run approximately 0.5 frames a second, which is very bad. So I'll go to playback, and I'm going to go to render cache, and I'm going to put this to smart render. And as you see, after render, it's running smoothly at 24 frames a second, which is quite nice. So on PC, we have the effect, and we'll see it's running 1.5 frames a second, a little more than the Mac, but nothing useful for playback. So again, we'll go into playback, and I'm going to render cache and put that to smart. And after rendering, you'll see it runs smoothly. Pretty nice. So for this test, we are doing a render test. So this piece of footage I am rendering out, it's a HD footage, and it's a combining of color grading, masking, and a lot of different effects and layers all combined into one compound layer. And here we're doing the render on the Mac. And as you see, the render of an HD file on Mac took around 1 minute and 19 seconds. Here we're doing the exact same test on PC, same format, everything the same. And the time for the PC was 1 second faster than the Mac. So now we're doing the exact same test, but in 4K. So I'm starting to do the render here in the Mac, and it's actually rendering it out pretty fast compared to a 4K file with all of the stuff that's involved in this video. And it did this in 2 minutes and 28 seconds. However, when I went to the PC and started render, I also were surprised that the render time was extremely long. In fact, it was so long that I had to take a coffee break and get me not one cup of coffee, but 4 cups of coffee. In fact, it was a very long render on the PC. It was 34 minutes, and on the Mac, it was 2 minutes and 28 seconds. Anyway, I do hope you found this little test useful. If you did, please hit that subscribe button, give the video a like, share it with your friends if you think it would help them out. And if you want to be notified every time there's a new video on this channel, please hit that bell icon down in the corner. Until next time, keep filming, keep learning, and keep sharing.